It's been a multi-year project, and we're in our third season. In 2011, the contractor began excavating and removing some of the existing structures, and over the past several years, we've continued to excavate, remove, and actually form and place. So the project removes the existing extremely long spillway and replaces it with a shorter length of overflow spillway, but most importantly, a series of large gates whereby we can control the reservoir elevation on Lake Walcott.
Right now, the next major section that they're building is the overflow spillways. We have two sections, a northern section and a southern section. They're concentrating working on the north section. The north overflow spillway will be one of two components that they'll finalize by the end of summer. That'll be the last major structural item of this project to be built.
Through the summer of 2014, the contractor RSCI is actually placing concrete within spillway blocks. And these blocks, when put together, assembled side by side on top of each other, actually form the spillway section.
It takes a lot of work to get the concrete placements, the blocks ready. They gotta clean the foundation or the previous placements. They gotta set up forms, install rebar, and then they have to soak the concrete below or rock, basalt foundation. And afterwards, they start pumping the concrete in. They're putting 10 plus hours, sometimes to get a placement ready. Just to get it ready, they'll work till late or during concrete placements until all of the concrete is placed. They have to keep up until it's done, it's topped off. So we've been here sometimes up to midnight placing concrete. This new structure will not have any weir, so it'll be full height to the Lake Walcott elevation, 42-45. If the reservoir for some reason overflows to above 42-45, it'll just overflow the new spillway.
One of the great benefits of the project is it reduces the labor-intensive process of removing and placing stock logs for over 1,000 feet. Basically, in order to control the elevation of Lake Walcott, Reclamation employees would actually have to go out and, using a long steel tool, reach in and pull out these heavy pieces of lumber. And they would have to do that over hundreds of bays. It's labor-intensive, it's inefficient, and this new spillway structure is really a modern 21st century design. Just several months ago, we saw the south gated spillway in action, releasing thousands of CFS into the Snake River as part of routine reservoir and river operations. We see flows going into both canals. We see the south gated spillway in operation, the north gated spillway in operation, and we can really see how this is going to operate in the future. It's been a great project for Reclamation. It's been a great project for our stakeholders. And it's been great to work with a local Idaho contractor, and I just see a win-win situation all around.